Andy, if you want one, we're gonna probably do a little breathing stretching drill with it at the end of class. So we will get started. Welcome to Move Well Thursday. Wow, March 25th, a week from today, is April Fool's Day. So will I be on or will I won't be on? I guess you'll have to tune in. Actually, you know what? I'm off next Thursday, so I probably won't be on, but plenty of videos now on our YouTube channel. So the days that I'm not on, you get your Move Well fix by going over to our YouTube channel at Webster Recreation, checking all the stuff we got out there. All right, we're gonna get right to it. So we're gonna do our lying on the back, feet up on a chair, 10 good breaths. We're gonna set that position, rib cage and our pelvis facing each other, kind of get to feel those abs working a little bit. Get that lower back in a nice, comfortable position. And then right from there, we'll turn that into a great ab exercise. And then from there, some mobility exercises. So let's get to it. Lots to do. We'll start off with the breathing. Make sure you guys can still see me. All right. So again, hips and knees 90 degrees, or close to that. Pressing my heels down into the chair, allow me to tilt that my pelvis back so my low back kind of flattens out and I start feeling those abs. And from here, I'm just going to focus on inhaling, expanding my rib cage all the way around towards the ceiling, out the sides, into the floor. On the exhale, I'm just going to let my body settle and into the ground. 10 good breaths. Here we go. But again, feeling those abs fire up. Got my ribs and pelvis in a nice good position. Keep my back in a good alignment. So now we're going to move over to, we're going to do a kettlebell pullover with a alternating leg lower. So combining some exercises that we've done in the past. Again, the whole idea with this exercise is set that position. So we're feeling the front side and we're not letting our low back arch excessively. So you don't want to think, feel anything uncomfortable in the lower back. It should be all on that front side. So we're going to do about 5 per side with that. So if you have any kind of weighted implement, kettlebells work great. Dumbbells doesn't have to be very heavy at all. I'll just focus on being in a good position. Alright, so let's start. Think about reaching towards the ceiling with that weight. As you exhale, tilt that pelvis back, flatten out that low back. Both legs are up and straight. Nice big inhale, and as we exhale, drop the weight overhead, drop one leg down, back up and inhale. So we'll do 5 per side. Also, if you tend to notice you start losing your position in your low back and you feel it in your low back and it's uncomfortable, you don't have to bring your legs all the way down to the ground. Just find that comfortable position that works for you. All right, the next thing we're going to do is a good glute and hamstring exercise. We're going to do some bridge with some walkouts. We've done this one before, it was a few weeks back, so I'll refresh your memory on this one. So again, we can take advantage of what we did in our breathing drill and the kettlebell pull over with the leg lower. And we want to set that same position, ribcage, pelvis facing each other, feeling those abs, keeping that low back in a good alignment. So that way we can focus on bridging up, using those backside muscles, our hips, our hamstrings, without letting that low back arch excessively. So what we're going to do, set that position, try to maintain it, just enough of a brace around your torso. So again, your low back's not moving excessively. And then we're going to come up. The key here now is to not let those hips drop if you can. We're going to walk out a couple of steps each leg. Walk them back. Lower it back down, keeping the torso braced. And we're going to repeat that 5 more times. So bridge up. Try not to let the hips drop. Try to minimize the side-to-side sway. Nice controlled reps. Lower it down. That's 2. Alright, we got a couple of mobility exercises. Give me one quick second. Alright. So the first one we're going to do is a good way to work on our hips' abilities to rotate internally and externally. A really nice variation. So hopefully you can see me okay with this. We're going to lie on our backs. Feet may be a little wider than your hips. It's So the key with this one is to keep your shoulder blades down, so arms out to the side. Make sure your head's down comfortably on the floor. And then we're just going to rotate side to side, dropping our legs side to side. We'll do about 8 per side. All right. The other thing we can do too is, as I drop my legs to the right, I'm going to rotate my head to the left so we can work on a little bit of mobility and rotation at our neck as well. Obviously an important thing to have. So it'll look like this. Just relax and breathe, take your time. Side to side. One hip drops in, the other one out. And just side to side. So try to get those knees as close to the ground as you can. Keeping those shoulder blades down, not forcing it. Breathe normally as you drop those legs down. Nice exhale, let the body settle. Inside the leg, allow us to kind of bring those hips in. A lot of times too, we're a little tight through there and through the groin, sometimes cause us a little bit of knee pain, so this is a really good one. Actually paired with a little bit of foam rolling beforehand, we've done that one before, but for our purposes today, try to have this kind of stance. You're on your knees on one, leg is straight. Try to get your foot as flat to the ground as you can. If your foot won't allow you to do that, just get as close as you can without forcing it. Then we're gonna bring our hands down. And then again, same idea, just enough of a brace around our torso so that we're moving through our hips. We're just not excessively moving through that low back. You know, a little movement is fine, certainly. And then we're just going to rock it back, feeling that stretch right in through here, that inner thigh, basically from the knee up to the groin, even into the lower leg. So we're just gonna rock it back. Then from here, we can rotate on our heel, rotate that hip out, and then come back. So we'll do 8 total per side. Just again, go to a comfortable range of motion. Switch sides. back to the top now with our kettlebell pullover. One thing I didn't mention at the beginning, but something that I always like to throw out there, find the variation that works best for you. If the straight leg lower with the pullover doesn't work, you keep your both feet down, focus on the pullover. If going overhead with the weight is a little bit problematic for you, just put the weight aside and just focus on the leg lower. Again, the whole idea with this exercise is to keep that lower back from arching excessively, putting a lot of strain on it, and not allowing us to get that nice stacked ribs over our pelvis position that we're looking for. So again, whatever variation, essentially it's a dead bug pattern. We've gone through a lot of those. I have some videos on our YouTube on how to progress those. So whatever works best for you, that's what I want you to do. Certainly progress it, certainly challenge yourself, but the main key is to be able to maintain and own that position and gradually build up your endurance and tolerance for that. So here we go. Alright, let's set that position, kind of gently push towards the ceiling as we exhale, tilt that pelvis back, bring up those legs, nice big inhale, as we exhale, kettlebell overhead, drop one leg down, and our goal is about 5 or so per side. Same idea as what I just mentioned with the first exercise. Main thing is master the basic movement. Once you have that, then you can add that walkout. It's going to be a lot more challenging to keep those hips from dropping or rotating side to side. So whichever one works best for you. Then we're going to set our position. I like to start with an exhale. Just kind of gently tilt your pelvis back, just so you feel those abs are on. Low back's in a nice comfortable position. And then we're going to focus on keeping it there as we use those backside hip muscles to lift up our hips. And then we'll add short little walkouts. Lower it back down. That's one. We'll do 5 more. And just practice breathing normally throughout, maintaining that good solid position. As we do it as well, use your breathing, nice normal breathing. We'll do another set of 8 per side. You just take your time, go to the range of motion your body can go, really focus on exhaling and just maybe get a little bit more range of motion. Again, not forcing anything. Here we go. One more set of rock bands. Actually, maybe for the second round, we'll do both at the same time. So we'll get our knees as wide as we can. Think about pushing or reaching away from the floor. We're just going to rock it back. Exhale, try to relax into it, hold it for 2 or 3 seconds, and then bring it up. We're going to do that 8 to 10 times. Again, try to control that position of your spine the best you can. A little movement's fine. Just enough of a brace, focus on rocking back through those hips. stretch like this is a great one to finish your day or to break up your work day. If you have a way you can get down on the floor and just open things up, relax and breathe. So next week, again, I won't be on live, but YouTube, you can always go to Webster Creation on YouTube and check out, I think we're over 200 videos now, all different types, yoga, some wellness talks, all that kind of thing. So again, if there's something you want to see, let us know. Hopefully we'll start seeing more and more of you here on site at the rec center. Weather's starting to get good. We'll be doing some classes outside. We got some new classes coming on our schedule. We have a new instructor. So a lot of cool things happening. We hope to see you all soon. Have a great weekend and have a great week next week.